Ever been waiting in line at the store for 5 minutes and it feels like it's like 20 minutes? You're kind of tapping your foot, you know, looking at your watch, thinking about how bad you want to tell the teller to hurry up. And most of the time you look around and people are kind of feeling the same way, but nobody says anything. The impatience and the frustration on their face might be visible at some time. Such an experience of waiting in line can seem isolating and lonely at times. Now think about the time that you wait in line going to an amusement park, you know, actually buying tickets for your favorite baseball team or even your favorite band that you like to listen to. In these instances, the waiting is a little bit more different. You know, you're a little bit more excited in line. You know, you're kind of talking about what the ride's about, or you're kind of talking about your favorite band and you're talking about maybe the favorite sport that you like, or even the band that you're about to hear. At Mass, after praying the Lord's Prayer, we hear. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. This prayer reminds us that during Advent, we wait in joy, in hope, and in anticipation for the wonderful event we are about to experience. The coming of Jesus Christ into our lives. The return of Christ at the end of time. During Advent, we await and look forward to celebrating the fact that God loves us so much that He sent His own Son into the world to save us. This waiting is far from empty. Rather, it is full of hope that God promises us as we prepare for Christ in the feast of Christmas. What's up, guys? Welcome back. I'm Sal. And today we're going to talk about the third week of Advent. Let's go ahead and begin with a prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Healing God, soften our hearts to make room for you. Detach us from our brokenness. Give us the courage to participate in your healing work wherever we are hurting. Having been set free from even the smallest of our sins, turn our hearts outward to be agents of your healing and new life in our homes and communities. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I don't know about you guys, but my patience is pretty bad. My wife is always telling me to take a chill pill and to relax, you know. I kind of dread, you know, the wrapping of the gifts and, you know, the credit card bills. They be piling up like crazy. And I feel bad because then I lose focus on, you know, what Advent is really about. You know, sometimes I feel like Christmas isn't all what it's out to be. Presents are open, then discarded, a lot of cooking, a lot of cleaning, you know. And there comes bad vibes around the family, such as anger. Then frustration starts to build and you feel like you can't relate to anybody. Even in the best of the Christmas moments, where people are the happiest and most peaceful, most in tune with God, there's still a sense of something missing. And Advent, on the other hand, is filled with its magic, which is often absent on Christmas Day. The feel of the Advent is one of preparation, of anticipation, of a great event that's about to happen. This week, I invite you to prepare for Advent by having a conversation with God. Every night before you go to bed, turn off your TV, turn off your cell phone, you know, and simply just talk to him about anything, you know, like he's your homie. You know, talk to him like about school, about your friends, you know, about your siblings, you know, talk to him about the situation that we have going on right now with pandemic, you know, talk to him about anything. Everything, and I promise you, he's listening. Let's see how our parishioners prepare for Advent.
The way I prepare for Advent is for different people. First of all, is my relationship with God, and in my prayer time, and I take time to reflect on the reading, specifically the reading of the day, and also I used to use the liturgy of the hours. And then after that, I look for the good communication with the community. And then every week of Advent, the 4 week, I have a different purpose, like joy, and I meditate on joy. And faith, I meditate on faith. And then light, because we know that the candles for the Advent is specific purpose of prepare for the coming of Christ. And then therefore, I try that Christ, when Christ come, not just come in the portal, but also Christ should be born in my heart, it grow in my heart. Therefore, I can be a disciple. I can be a good disciple, and then I can carry out my mission.
How do you prepare for Advent, Laura?
I try to go to confession prior to Advent season, and receive the sacrament of reconciliation. I set out my Advent wreath candle holder. Also, when our kids were little, I used to always have an Advent calendar for them to open nightly. And so now I do that for my grandkids, and I send them each an Advent calendar every season.
How do I prepare for Advent? I try to maintain my prayer time and go to confession and do a lot of singing, the coming of the Lord, Maranatha, come Lord Jesus, ready the way of the Lord, and keep those in my mind, and just prepare, just like John the Baptist was calling out that the Lord is coming, and look forward to Christmas and the Nativity and baby Jesus coming into the world to save us.
There are many ways I prepare for Advent. But my favorite one is I like to go in my room and I like to close the door and where there's no sound whatsoever, no noise. I like to pray the rosary starting every day from the first day we begin Advent. I like to spend a lot of time with our Blessed Mother. I pray to her, I ask her to intercede for all of us, to help all of us, not just me, but to help everybody else think about the second coming of Jesus. Think about just the coming in the coming of the Lord, period. So that's what I like to do to prepare for Advent.
The way I prepare personally for Advent, the best part, of course, is the third Sunday in which we light the rose candle. It's the joy that I experience, especially because the Lord is coming. The child Jesus is going to be born, and he is the Prince of Peace. And, you know, just think about the gift of peace. It's the one that we always need in our lives. And so that's the beautiful thing about Advent, that help us to not to prepare materially, because a lot of times we concentrate in the material aspect because of Christmas. And we are so busy, buying the present, the Christmas presents. And all of this time of Advent is to prepare our souls. That's the important thing, because we need a time of silence, a time of reflection, a time of going back to the Lord with all our hearts. And that is why I like the, especially the third Sunday, the third Rose Advent candle.
This week, we will light our third candle in our Advent wreath, pink, which means joy. Joy, the joy that you will experience when we meet our Savior at the Kingdom of Heaven. Remember, to be a Christian is to hope. The Christian faith, more than another, is founded on hope. Christian hope to see the world transform, to see a happy ending to humankind. Believers know that they won't see the fulfillment of this hope in their lifetime, just as they know that Christmas may not live up to their expectations. But Advent is a season of hope itself. The waiting, the longing, the dreaming is the stuff the Christian life is made of. Anticipating perfect joy, even when we cannot taste it yet. All right, guys, that's all I got for you guys today. Hope you guys learned something about the third week of Advent. Be safe out there. Hope to see you guys next week.